Security forces have gunned down two terrorists in Gopalpora village in Kulgam district in Jammu and Kashmir. In another incident, security forces are conducting search operation to flush out three terrorists reportedly holed up in Zainpora in Shopian district. Its first rate cut since October 2016, the Reserve Bank of India has slashed repo rate by 0.25% to 6%, citing reduced upside risk to inflation. EMI is said to be slashed as home loans, auto loans and personal loans are set to become cheaper. Southern Rail Network has got a boost. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved construction of doubling of railway line with electrification between Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala and Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu. The length of the line will be over 86 kilometres. The Union Cabinet has approved MOU between India and BRICS countries to set up BRICS Agriculture Research Platform. The Cabinet was also apprised of an MOU between India and Spain on cooperation in renewable energy. Several states continue to reel under monsoon mayhem. West Bengal has lost 4 lakh acres of standing crop. Central government has flagged off one batch of medicines and other relief material for Gujarat, Manipur and Assam. The BJP has slammed West Bengal government over corruption allegations against Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee and her nephew Abhishek Banerjee. The party has demanded the Chief Minister either come clean or resign. BJP President Amit Shah has exhorted workers in Haryana to strengthen the party at the ground level and prepare for Mission 2019. Amit Shah has asked the party representatives to take the government's initiatives to the people. IT department raids continue overnight at multiple locations in Karnataka and Delhi related to Karnataka Energy Minister D.K. Shivkumar in connection with the tax evasion probe case. The department has recovered 10 crore rupees in cash. The Maharashtra government has set up a committee to recommend measures to ensure safety of women working in the information and technology sector. The state government has apprised the Bombay High Court of the move. The enforcement directorate has got 2-day remand of Ambala native Kamal K. Bakshi in Unipay Group Ponzi scam investigation under Prevention of Money Laundering Act. The company is alleged to have lured thousands of innocent investors with promises of high returns on investment. India has responded to the Chinese assertions on Doklam. In response to a question on Chinese MFA's document released on the Doklam issue, MA spokesperson said that peace and tranquility must be maintained for smooth development of bilateral relations. The Indian Navy has court-martialed 2 naval sailors after finding them guilty of sexual offences. They've been sentenced to rigorous imprisonment for 15 years and 12 years, respectively. US President Donald Trump has signed sweeping sanction measures against Russia, Iran and North Korea. While Iran called it a clearly hostile act, Russia has said that the move amounts to full-scale trade war. The World Bank has said that India is allowed to construct hydroelectric power facilities on tributaries of the Jhelum and Chenab rivers under the 1960 Indus Water Treaty. The World Bank's comments came as officials from India and Pakistan concluded the secretary-level talks over the treaty. After a landslide victory in the first test, the Indian team will aim to take an unassailable 2-0 lead when they take on Sri Lanka in the second of the 3-test match series beginning in Colombo later today.